Now at 5, CBA debate. Mayor Henry's talking in depth about the three ordinances proposed in the collective bargaining debate. Good evening. Last Tuesday, City Council agreed to look at repealing collective bargaining for the nearly 1,300 city employees who are represented by unions.
But that won't happen if Mayor Tom Henry has anything to do with it. We've been following this story since the beginning of the month, and today, News Channel 15's Gina Glaro sat down with the mayor. She is in our newsroom with more on what he had to say. Gina?
Mark and Heather, Mayor Henry says this debate is politically motivated. He openly admits he'd veto all three ordinances. Here's why.
City Council voted 6-2 in favor of looking at repealing collective bargaining to city workers.
To make our taxpayers toil more just to provide benefits that the taxpayers don't receive is another side of the question that needs to be asked.
Today, we sat down with Mayor Tom Henry to hear his position on each of the three ordinances up for debate. The first, eliminating collective bargaining for all non-public safety employees. Mayor Henry says that's the most drastic.
I don't think that one's probably going to pass. But obviously, if it did, I would veto that.
Or consolidating six non-public safety unions to two bargaining agents.
When you say you're going to narrow it down to one or two, which ones? That should be their decision, not ours.
Finally, eliminating collective bargaining for police and firefighters, too. Mayor Henry says it's not a level playing field.
I don't think it's right to cut it off for some and not everybody. And so for that reason, I would veto that one as well.
So why does he think City Council is bringing up the issue now?
I personally feel that it's somewhat politically motivated.
He says that for two reasons.
What better way to show off a Republican-dominated City Council than them going to the Republican convention saying we were able to take away the collective bargaining rights of 1,300 city employees.
And the municipal election is in about a year and a half.
One of the city council members has already declared that he's going to run for mayor. I'm sure that there are those who feel that by putting the administration in an awkward position, it'll strengthen their side of the ticket.
Now, the earliest a decision can come is May 27th. If the mayor vetoes these ordinances, the council has to have six votes to override his veto. We're live in the newsroom. Gina Galeros, News Channel 15.